So oh, this is set.
Sharkbait and Lupin Fiasco versus Ben Shark.
Benjamin Button.
Get both.
Benji.
We got Genji and
Benji, which reminds me of the Behelit from Berserk, which summons the apocalypse.
Okay, I need to read that.
Yeah, you do.
I was planning on reading after I'm done Dojo. I'm still reading Part 8 right now. Part 8 is fucking black.
I haven't heard the last chapter yet. It's too bad fucking one chapter comes out a month.
Yeah,
so it's takes a little bit, you know.
They're not on the boat anymore, are they?
No, they haven't been for a while, but the girl's still retarded after like 20 years. Oh yeah, do you see the new, they're bringing Broly back in the new Dragon Ball movie?
I saw like a picture of him and he looked like Yamcha.
Well, his OG form looks kind of like Yamcha, yeah, like he's not powered.
Yeah.
Which I'm excited because he'll have a not stupid backstory.
Oh yeah, he's like, oh, you fucking cry beside me, I swear to God.
Yeah, okay. And also, he got completely bullshit in the first movie. He was like, invincible. Like, he ate the 100% Kamehameha to the face, and then, like, a single uppercut, and then he just kind of like, he's the main character, he's got beat up. Actually, I don't know who's worse by the real backstory, Jiren or Broly.
Isn't Jiren just, he's the ultimate guy.
No, Jiren's literally Batman. His backstory was literally just
parents dead.
Yeah, his family died. And then he made friends, and then his friends died, and he got angry and he became the strongest in the universe. Somehow stronger than literal gods. We don't know how he got that strength.
Now he's gotta fight and turn.
It was a cool fight, but he's really
Android 17's like, I got you.
Android 17 really powering up out of nowhere. Super was just the best.
Man, we made a weekly face-off. What happened to that?
Did we?
Yeah, Limit Breaker.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly, you forgot that sums it all up.
Yeah, the first week had like a decent
amount. Nothing. The second one actually had a decent amount. There's only really two.
I was kind of looking forward to that because it's going to have Dragon Ball Fighters, and then I don't like Dragon Ball Fighters. Oh, can't wait for that next DLC, by the way.
Yeah, well, who's that in now?
Base Goku. How exciting.
Man, I love playing as Goku, and Goku.
You can already do that, but now you can play
Vegeta. Now you can do even more.
Now you can play Vegeta, and Gogeta.
You're a giant of Vegeta. I can't wait to play as Glucose and Arvania.
They could add, you know, characters that people care about. But I guess we can't have their Goku. I don't know what they're going to do to make them interesting. Probably nothing, because all the characters are like,
isn't like the only unique one Zamasu?
Zamasu's not even that unique. He's got like a float mechanic.
And he has like balls.
He's got balls set up. Well, Beerus has balls. Zamasu has like these delayed projectiles, which are kind of cool. All the unique characters are bad. Includes Ginyu, Zamasu. Any character that has cool mechanics, same with Nappa, because Nappa's got a side mess, he's not good.
So,
all the actual good characters are the exact same.
Do you think he's gonna fucking do this?
I don't. But you know what?
Will he see the worth it? Will he survive? Rodeo. Survive the rodeo. Rodeo. Get that 90210.
For more than just love.
Nights like these, I wish I could do the impossible.
Yeah, that's what he's thinking right now.
as he's doing the impossible. Well, I can just think about it. Like, look at the movement, your hitbox is like half that fucking street. But the thing is, in a game like that with so much space, wouldn't you have to make hitbox and shit? I mean, it's a party game, so in that sense, you would.
I mean, that's the whole reason they, Red Team wins, by the way.
Yeah.
The whole reason they added all those flashy effects and stuff were to make the hitboxes appear larger. It's not, so you don't have, like, melee situations where characters have gigantic hitboxes for no reason.
Yeah. Even then, like, if you're designing the game for 1v1, then hitboxes should be small. But when you're designing it the way that Smash naturally is, like a party game, you play a million characters, you wouldn't want everyone having tiny hitboxes that you, like, you can't hit shit. But now that they're taken a more competitive aim with the next game, maybe things will be a bit less ridiculous.
Really looking forward to New Link, actually. I watched some footage of New Link.
Also seen footage. He has this cool stuff with his bombs. I thought his bombs were going to be a lot slower than I saw. But no, they're actually pretty fast.
They're for setups, man. Like, they're like remote mines.
It's pretty much Snake C4.
Yeah, but I believe C4 sends you directly up, whereas bombs can send you at an angle.
Yeah.
So the setups are much different.
So it functions similar to the C4.
Yeah. It's pretty exciting.
What does the C stand for in C4? Is it four Cs?
I don't know.
Like crazy, 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 crazy.
So, Link not having a tether grab is going to be really nice.
Yeah, well...
Tether grabs kind of suck.
Yeah, but that hurts his recovery a lot.
Not as much as he would think.
Well, with the directional air dodging, it's different, but that being said, he's, like, a lot of times where he's forced to up B so you can just hit him. So it does hurt his recovery.
It hurts his recovery a little bit, but his whole neutral's going to be better, because generally tether grabs aren't as good in the neutral.
Yeah.
Like, let's be real here. Zero Suit Samus would have a much easier time with a regular grab.
Yes, she would.
Because her only weakness is that her grab is really punishable because it's a tether grab.
Exactly. I'm upset the two framing is still a thing. I saw Ness do it to a Kirby because, like, when he charges the yo-yo, it hangs over the ledge. So that's not going to be obnoxious at all.
Maybe that's not two framing. I did hear the overall grab box for the ledges is much smaller. So perhaps you can hit someone just outside of the grab box.
Maybe. I don't know. It was just like an S against the Kirby, and it looked like a two frame with the yo-yo.
Maybe the yo-yo because I've heard that.
I don't know, there's a lot of I heard this, I heard that. We don't know for sure until the game's released. But think about when the game is released. Like, everyone's gonna be... I'm gonna go on Twitter and just constantly see a million conflicting opinions about what works, what
doesn't. At the end of the day, we're just gonna be fine.
Yeah, like, after a few months when the meta deck is, like, reborn. But at first, like, the game's gonna be, like, a nightmare to play. Like, nobody knows what they're doing.
And so many people are coming from this game, so they're gonna play the game similar to this before everything else has been discovered. I guarantee you, like, a lot of people are not actually gonna be capitalizing on the nails dodging. Yeah, because everyone's so used to rolling, like, so easily in this game. It sucks that you can't do the dodging line, though. Like, sometimes you just, like, spot dodge five times.
So please put Hikachi.
Yeah, one Hikachi.
Dude, I'm actually seeing like a decent amount of people rallying behind Heihachi in this match.
That would be cool.
I'm kind of like, why, but at the same time, like, that would be cool.
Like, think about it. Heihachi versus...
I'm pretty sure Heihachi has only been on, like, just the Radiant Tekken. I think that's the only Tekken game that's been on there.
Man, now it's Heihachi. I would, like, lose my shit.
I think Nightmare is probably more likely.
What about Scarfrin from Mortal Kombat? Yeah.
I could see Nightmare from SoCal being added because SoCal's actually been on Nintendo consoles, and also Nightmare, like, you can use remote to do SoCal. I'm really looking forward to SoCal.
You know what's funny? They went in the forest, and now everyone's up to blow. It's not called Clone anymore, it's called Echo Fighter, except that it's the exact same fucking thing.
Exact same thing.
But people love it now because it has a name.
Now it's like...
That's one of the stupidest things.
Go on the subreddit, it's like, here's all my suggestions for Echo Fighter.
Yeah, like, they have like a giant, it's like, no.
Dude, I've been saying for years, literally since before Smash 4 launched, that, like, clones are really cool. They take, like, almost no time to develop in comparison to, like, an actual character. And everyone was just like... No, but they take up slots. If we didn't have Dark, we could have Ridley, am I right?
No, because of the copy paste.
Because Ridley definitely took the same amount of time to make his Dark.
I just don't like that it's like we have like a bunch of characters that are the same thing as other ones.
I think it's cool as it's done. Like, I have no Dark.
I would love to see them add Shadow, but not only do I think if he was an Echo Fighter, that would be weird. Because moveset, like Sonic moveset, you don't really see Shadow doing the exact same thing. I can see that like being a meme, but
Shadow is jumping.
something cool that you can do is, like, even, like, for, like, a dash attack, like, the brawl one, but he has the lane effect on it, like, the long mix too. I feel like that.
Echo fighters are kind of inconsistent, too. Like, Dr. Mario isn't considered an Echo fighter.
No, but like, even an Echo move.
No, but he has, like, two new moves.
What's the other one?
Well, he's got, like, his stomp, he's got a stomp, he doesn't have flat. Like, his down beat's different. That's, like, the only thing he has different, and that's enough to make him not considered an Echo Fighter, even though the rest of his kids are the same. I suppose Echo Fighter is, like...
Echo Fighters aren't just, like, Mario and Luigi are basically the same thing.
They don't.
Except they don't.
They don't.
They did for...
They did, yeah.
They did, but they don't.